A function is a prescription that links every value in its domain to a value in its codomain. In this video, we'll encounter two other sets that are very important for functions: the kernel of a function and the range of a function. The kernel is a subset of the domain, and the range is a subset of the codomain. And what are these sets and why are they important for us? That's what you will learn in this video. So, what's the kernel of a mapping T from the domain to the codomain? Well, it's kind of easy. It's a set of all vectors in the domain that are mapped to 0. So, a set of all vectors which image is 0. So, how can you see whether a vector is in the kernel or not? Plug it into your function. If you get 0, then the variable is in the kernel, and if you don't get 0, it's not. Then the range. That's a subset of the codomain. Looks a bit more complicated, but it's in fact a set of all values you can actually reach. So if you have a function, you map to your codomain. Sometimes you cannot reach all values, but the set of values which you can in fact reach, that's called the range of your function. How far your function is ranging, basically, hence the name. So the official notation, the points y in the codomain that you can reach, so the points such that there is some x in the domain such that the image equals y. So the formula look kind of complicated, but the idea is actually not that hard. Just the points that where you can come in the codomain. So let's do a very simple function in our example, mapping the set of 2, 3, and 4 to the set 0, 1, 3. So the domain of our function consists of just 3 points, 2, 3, and 4. And the codomain of our function consists also of 3 points, 0, 1, and 2. Now, 2 and 3 are mapped to 0, 4 is mapped to 2, and you can reach 1. So, what do we see? What is the kernel of our function? Well, the set of all values that is mapped to 0. Well, what function values are mapped to 0? Well, 2 and 3. So, in this case, the kernel of our function t will be the set consisting of 2 and 3. So, what's the range of our function? Well, it's the set of values in the codomain that we can actually reach. You see, we can't reach 1, we can only reach 0 and 2, so the range of our function t will be 0, 2. And you see, indeed, the range over here is a subset of the codomain, and the kernel is a subset of the domain of the function t. Now, let's do a second example, a bit more complicated, a function from R to R. If you have our function f of x equals x squared minus 1, so what's the domain and the codomain? We can read off directly what the domain and the codomain are. Domain of R, codomain also of R. Determining kernel and range is usually a bit more difficult. The kernel is all a set of all values which are mapped to 0. So you are looking for x such that x squared minus 1 equals 0. Well, you can solve that equation. You get x equals minus 1, x equals 1. So the kernel of f consists of 2 points, minus 1 and 1, because those two are mapped to 0. What about the range? That is in general also a harder question. But in this case, you know, hey, this x squared is always positive. So you have minus 1 plus something which is always positive. So you are mapping two values which are either minus 1 or larger. And you can reach all larger values by making x large enough. So the range of your function f in this case would be minus 1, infinity. So now you have seen what the kernel and the range of a function are, and you see that even in this not so difficult example, f of x equals x squared minus 1, you already have to be quite careful if you want to determine the kernel and the range of a function.